welcome back to CameraFi STUDIO tutorial. In the last two videos, we talked about the scoreboard. Today, I'd like to explain the real-time caption feature. Real-time caption in CameraFi STUDIO supports open caption and closed captions. In addition, it provides useful functions when using captions, such as speech-to-text, translation, filtering, and so on. This video will talk about how to create, edit, and apply real-time captions to live streaming encoders. Before we start the explanation, in the case of real-time caption, you can use it more conveniently if you connect the keyboard. The example screen is a computer, but you can also use it by connecting a Bluetooth keyboard on a mobile phone. Let's get started. To create the real-time caption, sign in to CameraFi Studio and tap the real-time captioning button. The Create Caption page will be loaded. In the General tab, enter the title. Other elements are optional, so to enter or not is up to you. Tap Save and the real-time caption is created. The captioning page will appear after you tap Save. You can see the Switch and Settings button on the top of the page. With the Switch button, you can change the position of the input and the output, and the Settings button is linked to the Caption Settings page. When you type the text in the input and send it, the caption preview will be displayed on the output. You can also send text by using the Enter key of the keyboard. Below the input section, you can set speech to text, translation, text to speech, and filtering options. To use speech to text, you have to allow the microphone to access and turn it on. For translation, text to speech, and filtering, you must activate them. The current status of these three features is displayed with the blue text. If you click the deactivate text, the options are activated to the default value and you can set the values as needed. Don't forget to save after you change the settings. If you scroll down the page, you can set the caption design. You can choose one of the styles provided by CameraFi Studio and customize the background color, text color, font, and font size. Some caption designs can indicate the speaker. Click the settings button to use these designs. Go to the Open Caption menu, find Caption Style, and select the Speaker Indicatable Style. Next, tap plus button of the Add Edit Speaker. The thumbnail type can be selected between image and text. If you select the image, you can choose the thumbnail image to be displayed in the place of the speaker. The selected image will be the thumbnail of the speaker and be displayed in front of the caption. If you finished editing speakers, save the settings and you can see the speaker are displayed below the input section. Select the speaker and send the text. You can see the speaker thumbnail appears on the left side of the caption. Below the caption style, you can see the load. You can check the history of sent caption and send it again through the resend button. Download caption history below the log allows you to download and save the log contents as a CSV file. If you click the stop captioning next to it, the caption will no longer be available and you can only check the log in My Channel, Real-Time Captioning, Past Captions. I mentioned earlier that the CameraFi Studio supports open captions and closed captions. Open captions can be accessed by pasting the Open Caption Overlay URL on the platform that supports web overlay. If you use CameraFi Live, log in with the same account as CameraFi Studio and go to the widget Web CameraFi Studio. You can see the real-time caption you created in CameraFi Studio and use them right away. Closed captions are available in a variety of encoder software like OBS, YouTube, and Zoom. For more information on how to use it, please check out the CameraFi blog. Utilizing the caption can significantly enhance the quality of your live streaming. If you have any questions for real-time caption, please check the CameraFi blog. Don't forget to subscribe our channel to stay updated with the latest video releases. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.